In this video, I want to take a look at a derivation rule known as conditional introduction. Conditional introduction says that from a subproof that begins with the assumption P and ends with Q, we can derive the conditional P right arrow Q. That is, if we assume P, and under this assumption we derive Q, we can derive a conditional from that reasoning that we've done under the assumption and to the derivation of Q, to the conditional P right arrow Q. So take a look here. What we have is a assumption right here. We assumed P. Then through using the deductive apparatus, that is, we just kind of used our various derivation rules, we, under this assumption, reason to Q. Now once you've made this assumption and then derived a particular formula of your choosing or whatever you kind of want, then you can derive a conditional from this entire subproof where the antecedent of the conditional is the formula that you assumed and the consequent of the conditional is the formula that you derived in the subproof. Another way of thinking about conditional introduction is that you make an assumption. Let's say you assume S and then you reason to, let's say, L. You said under this assumption, if S is the case, then L is the case. And so conditional introduction simply summarizes the reasoning that went on in this subproof right here. That is, under this assumption S, you derived L. And so you can summarize this entire subproof right here with a single formula, which is if S, then L. Let's take a look at a particular example of conditional introduction. Here we have a proof where we want to reason from R to the conditional if Z then R. Now at first glance, it might be kind of curious, how are we going to derive Z, or how are we going to get Z into this proof if we don't have it in our premises, if we aren't beginning with it? Well, one of the ways to do that is to make an assumption. So you'll notice that we set up the proof here at line one, we simply write R, and then the goal of this proof is to get the conditional if Z then R. So we want to form this conditional. We want to introduce into the proof a conditional. And conditional introduction says that if you assume Z and derive R, then you can derive the conditional if Z then R, which is the formula that we want. So line two, what we do is go ahead and assume Z. And now the goal of this subproof is somehow to get R, just like we kind of indicated over here. And we can do that. We can get R into the subproof by first using an earlier rule that we talked about, conjunction introduction, with lines 1 and 2. We took line 1, line 2, and formed a conjunction from them. Then, since we have a conjunction at line 3, we can derive R from that conjunction using conjunction elimination. So now what we've done is we've assumed Z, and we've derived R. That is, we assume Z and show that if under the assumption Z is the case, then R is the case. And conditional introduction says that if you assume a particular formula and then derive a formula, then you can summarize that or derive into the proof the conditional if Z then R. The basic idea behind conditional introduction is that if you assume a formula and show that a particular formula follows from that formula, then you can derive a conditional from that. So if you assume B, derive another formula, Q or R or whatever, then you can derive a conditional from that. So let's consider an example in plain English. Let's assume that, just assume that a nuclear bomb is dropped on my house. Let's make this assumption. We're not saying that it is the case. We're just saying, let's assume. So assume or suppose that a bomb is dropped on my house. Bomb is dropped. Okay, from this assumption, let's say from, you know, using the derivation rules as well as some other maybe formulas that are found in the proof, that if this bomb is dropped on under the assumption that the bomb is dropped, then my house will be destroyed. So I say, okay, I assume this particular bomb is dropped right here. And now through using the various rules or in conjunction with the formulas that are in the proof, I can show from this that the house, my house, will be or is destroyed. Now, from this assumption right here, and from this kind of conclusion that we reached in this subproof, that is from the conclusion we derived under this assumption, we can use conditional introduction to derive the conditional. If the bomb is dropped on my house, bomb is dropped, then, so we're driving this conditional from this assumption, right, from this like little subproof up here, then house destroyed. So you see how conditional introduction corresponds to, let's say, an everyday form of reasoning. People make assumptions or suppositions all the time. We say, okay, we don't know whether or not this is the case or not, but let's assume it and see what follows from that. And given that you can show a particular formula follows from that assumption, you can kind of summarize that reasoning there with a conditional. Say, well, if a bomb is dropped on the house, then it's going to follow that the house is destroyed. Let's look at two more examples of using conditional introduction. In the first example, let's consider we had the premise P and Q, and we want to derive the formula Z and X, then Q. So you'll notice that we don't have Z or X in the premises, but the claim is that from P and Q, we can show using the deductive apparatus that Z and X, then Q follows. So we set up the proof, P and Q. Then, one of the things to note is that the goal of this proof is a conditional. That is, we want to introduce into the proof a conditional. So we can start by saying, you know what? I just need to assume the antecedent of the conditional and then try to get the consequent. So I'm going to assume Z and X. And you can assume whatever formula you want. You can assume it can be a contradiction. It can be any formula of any complexity. So I'm going to assume Z and X. And the goal of this subproof is to show that Q follows. And I can get Q into the subproof. That is, I can reason to Q by saying, well, if P and Q are the case, and under the given that P and Q are the case, and under the assumption Z and X are the case, I can reason to Q using line 1, conjunction elimination. I'm reasoning from this conjunction at line 1 to Q at line 3. Now what I've shown here is that if Z and X are under this assumption Z and X, Q follows. And so I can summarize that subproof, that is, I can legitimately derive into the proof if Z and X, then Q. I can reason to this conditional using the subproof, so lines 2 through 3, and conditional introduction. Let's look at another example. In this example, we'll look at a particular proof that doesn't involve any premises. We'll say that we can derive P and P, then P. That if P and P are the case, then P is the case. And we can do this from zero premises. So to start, what we'll have to do is make an assumption. And the assumption is going to be based upon this conditional right here. We want to derive a conditional. And so we'll start by assuming the antecedent of this conditional and then trying to derive the consequent of this conditional. Because we're going to do this to form a conditional at the end. We want to make an assumption P, derive Q, and then reason to P and Q. But here, since formulas are a little bit different, we'll make different assumptions. But essentially what we're going to do is the same thing. We're going to assume the antecedent of the conditional and then try to derive the consequent. So we'll start by assuming the antecedent of the conditional, P and P. This is making an assumption, and the goal of this formula is to derive P. Next, we can reason to P simply by using conjunction elimination from line 1. We have a conjunction P and P, so we can reason to P. And then at line 3, we can reason to P and P, then P, using 1 or 1 through 2 conditional elimination. That is, we assumed P and P. We derived P from this formula, from the assumption. And then from this, we can say, well, under the assumption P and P is the case, it follows that P is the case. So we can say, if P and P is the case, then P is the case. So this shows how we can make use of conditional introduction without any premises at all. The thing to keep in mind, though, is when we want to make use of conditional introduction, we always are looking at the type of formula that we're trying to derive. When we're trying to derive a conditional, we might want to make use of this rule.